Oh no, this isn't good.
What is it?
Smoke, over there, by the hamlet. Felkoff's in trouble. They're under attack.
Let's hurry.
What have you done?
Saved my sister.
With an unforgivable curse. From that damned book, no doubt. Your father would be ashamed. You've gone too far, Sebastian. Stay away from her. From all of us.
What did my uncle expect me to do? The Imperius curse saved Anne's life. That goblin was going to kill her.
You did what you had to do.
If I have to keep proving that to my uncle, I will. He cannot banish me from my own home. From my sister.
It might be best to let him calm down a while. May I speak to him? Perhaps I can help to ease the tension a bit.
You may be right. Very well. Probably best if I get away from here for a while. I'll head back to Hogwarts.
What was he thinking?
Pardon me, Mr. Sallow.
What Sebastian did was inexcusable. You cannot possibly be about to defend him.
Sebastian and I have encountered Ranrok's loyalists before. That goblin would have killed Anne.
This family does not resort to using dark magic, even against our enemies. What Sebastian did cannot be undone. That you are defending Sebastian's behavior at all tells me everything I need to know. You are as guilty as he is. Sebastian is to come nowhere near Feldcroft, nowhere near Anne. Unforgivable curses are so named for a reason. If I hear that either of you continues down this path, if either of you uses dark magic, I will notify the headmaster immediately. Why, Sebastian?
Alohomora.
What do we have here? A demigod.
Revelio.
Likely this astronomy table will be best used when it's dark.
Revelio.
Accio.
closer.
Revelio.
I can't believe we found ourselves trapped in that scriptorium.
Speak with my uncle.
I wish I had better news about your uncle and Anne.
Well, what did he say?
I'm afraid he wants you nowhere near Felthcroft. Nor Anne.
I had to stop that goblin from killing my sister. He had no right to banish me from my own twin. If he thinks banishing me means I'm going to give up on Anne, he's sorely mistaken.
He also said he cannot excuse the use of dark magic in any form. And that if he hears of either of us using it, he'll go straight to Professor Black.
Huh. That relic, dark magic or not, is the key to saving Anne. To reverse that curse. I will not lose Anne for good. I should send the crest to Anne. She'll know that we need to meet.
I'm afraid I don't follow.
Nothing, just a thought. Now I'm more determined than ever to learn what power that relic has.
What did you mean you'd send Anne a crest so that she'd know to meet you?
We just lost our parents, and we were packing up to go and live with Solomon. We couldn't take everything. She was carefully organizing her prized possessions. A box of artifacts she'd collected to do with our family. Jewelry, cards, old photographs. She got to her favorite, a handmade crest,
and without a second thought, she handed it to me. "This will keep you safe," she said. "It holds no enchantment, but I've kept it with me since. That's how I can reach Anne. I'll get the crest to her with plans to meet."
"Be careful, Sebastian. Your uncle could intercept it, or be expelled."
"Even if Ominous is upset with us, he has no love lost for his family. He'd use their connections to the headmaster if we needed his help."
"I shall wait to hear from you then."
"Thank you. I very much appreciate you standing by me through all of this. I'll send you an owl when I have news."
Off on another adventure, are we? So frustrating. You wanted to speak with me, Mother?
I had hoped to speak with you alone, Natsai.
Your message mentioned your concern about an unusual creature that was spotted in the woods near Hogsmeade. That could have been anything.
You know what it was, Natsai.
I am allowed to leave the castle. I am always careful, Mother.
Careful? Officer Singer disagrees. She sent me an owl telling me that you have been trying to collect evidence of some kind against dark wizards. She berated me for not keeping a closer eye on you. And she is right. I do not want you visiting Hogsmeade for the near future.
But Mother!
My little gazelle, you are well-intentioned. But you must not meddle in the affairs of dangerous people.
If someone had meddled in Matabele Land, Father would still be with us.
I must get to class. Perhaps your friend can get you to listen to reason.
So frustrating. She never listens to me.
She called you her little gazelle. Is that a term of endearment where you're from?
It is specific to me. I am the unusual creature in Hogsmeade she mentioned. Self-transfiguration is not taught at Hogwarts, so I am gently discouraged from practicing it. However, I am an animagus. And it is in my gazelle form that I have been able to wander the highlands rather freely until now, much to my mother's chagrin. That is how I managed to spy on Rookwood and Harlow.
Were you born an Animagus, or did you learn to become one?
Animagi are not born. The process is quite elaborate. It involves holding a mandrake leaf in one's mouth for an entire month, then placing the leaf in a crystal phial so that it is imbued with moonlight, then adding one of your own hairs. And that is just the beginning. Self-transfiguration is common among students at Wagadu, but Professor Weasley considers it much too dangerous to teach at Hogwarts.
Can you choose what form your Animagus will take?
Oh, no. A person's Animagus form is determined by their personality. My mother is convinced that my form is a gazelle because I adapt well to any situation. I believe it is because I can sense danger and keep my wits about me.
How does it feel to transform into an animal?
Well, the first time, it can be a bit unnerving. I felt a kind of searing pain and a strong double heartbeat. But it gets easier the more you do it. I no longer feel any pain, and I must say, I find a sense of comfort in the double heartbeat. And I love being able to view the world from a different perspective.
Now the nickname makes sense. What an extraordinary ability to have.
It is. I love transforming, but Mother is less enthusiastic about it. She says that no creature, especially one as rare as a gazelle, should be bounding about where poaching has become so prevalent. She claims that she has foreseen tragedy befall me in my gazelle form. But she has used her sight to control me too many times. I no longer believe it.
She's concerned for your safety. It may be best for you to stay away from Hogsmeade for now.
That may be safe, but I do not believe that it would be best. Do you? You could have fled the moment you discovered that Rookwood, Harlow, and Randrock were after you, but you did not. I choose to act as you have. I must deal with Rookwood and Harlow, not hide from them. My mother cannot know where I am all the time. Thank you for being here during that rather awkward conversation.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Revelio. Revelio.
Else too. A dash of powdered bat spleen, I think.
Alohomora.
Mind now, demiguys.
Revelio.
Yeah. thing's clean as a whistle, but it's... Oh, what's that vile stench? Oh, what is that portrait doing?
Revelio. Oh,
humiliation.
Lumos.
Oh dear, do mind the tiles. Some of them can be most potent.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Lumos.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio. Revelio.
I can't believe we found ourselves trapped in that scriptorium. Never again.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio.
Lumos. Lumos. Lumos.
Alohomora.
I had said I would.
You should. You should ask her.
Shan't hold my breath for that.
No. I'm going to ask her this time.
You said that 40 years ago.
Did you see that? She looked at me.
My dear mound of shoulders, I'm afraid it was I that drew her gaze.
I'm going to do it.
You should, before the next century.
Oh, for heaven's sake, get on with it.
Milady, would thou takest my hand in dance?
Oh.
I did it. I asked her.
Forgetting anything?
No, goodness. Milady, might I borrow my body, perchance? Milady?
Care to dance?
Thought you'd never ask.
What a handsome couple we make.
Revelio.